Hello, good evening and welcome. And you join us today back on the fives. It's about 10 o'clock at night and we've just got up. I've just finished my little waddle around the deck and everyone seems to be driving the wrong way this evening, which drives me absolutely bonkers. So after 5 kilometres of stumbling around in this sweaty night, I thought I'd stop and do a bit of vlog. Talk today about the passage of time, Sitting here last night and usually I like to ring home and everything and turn the data on. And just at the crack of midnight, the 3-month contract on the data stick ran out, and that was the end of that. So no more SIM card there, and it's just to show you, it's like a little milestone in my mind of like, yeah, it's time to go home, you've done your 90 days. So yeah, what have we done during this 90 days? We've been in the bin twice, that's been lovely. Actually it hasn't, it's just been in the bin. And on the second time I've been in the bin, it's been Ramadan. So thankfully, some guy's gone up in a plane and seen the moon. And today, alhamdulillah to all my Muslim friends, it's Eid, Eid al-Adha, the Feast of the Slaughter. A very good time for a nice dinner and a bit of a special meal here, but a very, very bad time to be anything with four legs out in the Middle East having their throat cut. So, we're on for a nice dinner this evening. We'll give you a little look at that later. And what does it mean? Well, usually Ramadan is like this prime example territory of time for all the locals and the whole situation out here to just slack off. Obviously this doesn't really affect us because we just keep going on, but if there was a way of annoying your pancreas by not giving it any food for 16 hours a day, that's got to be it. At the end of it they like to stuff themselves, and this Eid meal, this big feast that we're going to have, is all to do with that. On other vessels we've been on, they've actually brought on a live goat and chopped its throat up, and then we've eaten the goat. I don't know where I stand on goat. My favourite means of eating goat is probably the goat curry. Goat tends to taste like goat smells, and if you've ever smelled a proper mountain goat, I smell some up in Scotland, you smell them before you see them, they're minging, absolutely minging. But yeah, curried up, not too bad, but we'll see what we get for lunch. Traditionally it is curried lobster and butter chicken, an aquatic diorama of a frozen fish in a bucket with some seaweed, about a million different kinds of over-sugared Indian sweets. It really is death for the pancreas out here. You just can't make enough insulin just to cope with all the sweet stuff. I tend to avoid all of that. So yeah, Eid. Also, today we're just coming into second. Some of our friends who are relieving us are coming out, who have flown yesterday, so they're in the country, probably in the camp, bewailing their fate. And on the 5th there's the crew boat, and we can get the fuck out of here, which is tremendous because, you know what I mean, we've done 3 months, we've run out of data, it's time to go home. 3 months is one of those things that you miss an entire season, and then you miss an entire season. So last time a friend of mine was going back and it was going to be his summer, now he's going back, it's his winter, and I'm coming back into sort of late spring. Apparently the weather at home is quite nice and it's going to be the Maybank holiday, so I'm quite looking forward to that and just getting back to being a bit more normal. Oh, hang on, where we are, follow me with the thing. Yeah. Oh. Obviously I'm out of practice with this because we've been in the bin for a month. So yeah, that's what we're going to get up to today. So Eid Mubarak, and stay tuned. Well, here we are, ladies and gentlemen, and existing subscribers, and we're on shift. So we'll just get rid of some of this stupid PPE. What am I doing? What am I doing? I do wonder. Oh, right, yeah, I'm sitting here in the standby chair with a cushion under my arse because it's all stiff. And there's some gentleman in the water who's picking up a bendy pipe. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, that's probably enough of that work. Anyway, so yeah, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about what's going to go on today. There's going to be a big feast to celebrate the end of Ramadan Madengon. And they've already put some Ramadan decorations up. They do tend to go a bit OTT with it. And some of the decorations are howling. But yeah, that's today's fun and games. There's some diving shit going on. The other shift didn't appear to do very much. They had some DP failure or something wobbled and had to stop. So we've come back on shift today and it's in exactly the same position. So we're going to be out here all day. It's quite sticky this evening, and which gets a bit much because I was all wet and clammy yesterday and it's not much fun really. So yeah, just another day like this. Today is the 2nd. The boat is on the 5th. It can't come too quick enough. But there's a definite feeling of the passing of something. And moving on, and started to think a little bit about the bigger picture of what's actually happening. When we blew this out the first time, the war in Ukraine kicked off. When we blew this out the second time, the war in Ukraine just kept getting worse, and now I'd really wish it had stopped. Obviously, our window to the world is the BBC News and the internet, which tends to be a little bit partisan. Everyone's getting fixated about this MP who was caught looking at some bongo on his phone in the House of Commons. It's like, are we really bothered about lockdown pints of beer and parties when you've got some madman out there who's finger on the nuclear button, the chemical weapons and everything? You know, can we have a sense of perspective, please? Anyway, such is life. And just another bloody day. Right then, you join us for the Eid al-Adha special meal. Come and check out what we have to enjoy today. As you can see, they've properly jingled everything up. Check it out. Look at that. Love. Jesus, you can kill a diabetic with that cake. Thing. Fantastic. It is. Full selection of sweets, baklava, jellabies, all kinds of bread. Very nice. How about that? That's a lovely display, all that fruit. What have we got going on here? Samosas, falafel, spring rolls, fresh vegetables. Nice prawn looking things. And it wouldn't be Eid without a goat. Let's go in for the eyeball.
Oh, yeah.
Still the eyeball's still there. That's the favourite bit.
The ring of
nice.
Fire. The ring of fire.
check that out. With his aubergine face and carrot ears. Who says Ireland's dead, not dead? Look at this amazing selection. Hummus, chilies, salad, Greek salad, baba ghanoush, coleslaw, chickpeas, kind of a fried bread thing, what might be guacamole, nice salads, it's all here. Okay, so check these guys out. This is the first time we've all sat down to eat. First time we've all sat down to eat together for what seems like ages. We don't tend to do it, we tend to rush in here and just have something to eat and then bugger off. But today we're going for it. Look at that grassini. That looks good, doesn't it?
Yeah. I fell for you like a child.
What's the main event, other than the goat? And we've got some shawarma, some kebabs, some prawns. They look good, are they nice? They're good. Chicken. Rice.
And it burns.
Lots of chicken, nice for things to eat. Very nice, thank you. Well done, everybody, that was great. So there you have it. Eid Mubarak, everybody.
And it burns. The ring of fire. The ring of fire. And it burns.